Right, here's one of my personal favorite California native plants. This one's coastal sagebrush, Artemisia californica. And it's actually not technically a sage, it's part of the sunflower family, but it has extremely aromatic leaves, and it smells amazing, especially in the morning or in the evening when it's moist and dewy out. The smell just carries. When it does flower, it attracts tons of beneficial pollinators and native bees and flies and other insects. The Chumash have used this for millennia for a number of things. Medicinally, this was boiled down into a tea or a decoction and drank for sore throats and for fevers and other flus. Topically, it is antiseptic, so it can be used as a skin wash. And it also has, because of its highly aromatic leaves, was used by hunters to prepare for a hunt. So after going into a sweat lodge and scraping off the sweat and jumping into a river, they would rub this all over their body, and it would help enable them to get closer to the animals to have a more successful hunt. This is probably one of the more common plants that can be seen all throughout the hills surrounding this area. It grows very quickly, and especially right after fire, it's one of the first plants to resprout. I know here after the Woolsey fire, the whole hills were completely black and charred, and within a few months, there were sagebrush plants sprouting up everywhere. Here we have Bladderpod, Peritoma arborea. Now this plant doesn't have that many uses for the Chumash, but it was eaten and prepared. But something that's really neat about it are these big seed pods that smell extremely acrid, but if you boil them lightly or steam them, I guess they taste like asparagus. But this plant is really interesting for a few reasons. First, these beautiful flowers attract plenty of pollinators and bees during the springtime when it starts to bloom. But also, it's really, really easy to grow. We did a test last year, and of all of the seeds that we planted, nearly every single one of them sprouted into a new plant. And you can see around the base of this, there's already a bunch that are starting to sprout up from the fallen seed pods last year. This plant looks different when it grows in different environments. Here, it's pretty shady, and it's not too windy, so this plant is growing tall and big. But I've seen plants like this over on the coastline where it's really windy and cold, and they are virtually unrecognizable. The seed pods are very, very small, the flowers are tiny, and the branches are all really, really close and bent down to the ground. Here we have Western Vervain, or Verbena lasiosticus. This plant has been used by the Chumash for millennia for pulmonary complaints and for rheumatism. Now this is part of the Verbena family, and there's over 250 varieties, all native to Northern America. These flowers are beautiful and bright purple, and in the springtime, you'll often see honeybees and a lot of other beneficial pollinators hovering around. The Spanish actually called this bee food because it's so popular with the bees. Here we have Coyote Brush, Baccharis pilularis, and this plant's cool for a few reasons. First of all, it's really evolved to thrive in the chaparral environment. The waxy leaves have a substance in there that's a fire retardant. It also helps to preserve water during the hot, dry summers. The Chumash have used this for millennia for a few reasons. First was to decoct or to boil down the leaves to use as a wash for poison oak rash. And it also used the branches to clear the spines off of prickly pear cacti. Now, this is also a really, really popular plant with native pollinators such as bees and flies and other insects. And it flowers between like August and December. And during that time, there's just usually this bush will just be buzzing with bees and all types of insects that are attracted to the really fragrant small white flowers. Here we have Rue's integrifolia, or lemonade berry. Now this plant has really tart, sour berries that fully mature late summer, early fall. This berry right here is just starting to form, and they won't mature until later this summer. Now when these berries are fully matured, they have a very, very sticky substance all around them. If you've ever had a warhead, it tastes just like that. It makes your jaw clench. Now that sour taste is due to the citric acid or the vitamin C and a number of other bioflavonoids present in the plant. The Chumash would eat these berries after drying them in the sun, or they would mix them fresh in with water and drink it as a lemony beverage on hot days. In Southern California, we don't have a lot of fruits. We have mostly berries, and it wasn't until much later that other types of fruits were introduced to the area. So these were a very, very important part of the Chumash diet.